Right. So, daily living, unit 9. Right. So let's look at picture. Okay. Wait, this is unit 10. Never mind. Excuse me. Correct. Here we go. By page what? 110. Okay. So what do we see? Where is this?
Ben, pass the vacuum.
No. Where is it? Where is it?
A home.
It's a home, right? Okay. So what parts of the home do we see? What areas of the home?
Kitchen.
Okay. That's the kitchen here, right? There's the kitchen, and maybe they have a little breakfast table over here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And back there, what is this back there where Lucas is?
Lucas,
oh.
Yeah, what is it? What is that called? The area?
Cleaning.
A bathroom. Very good. That's the bathroom, okay? So you know what's the difference between restroom and bathroom?
Back then, you see?
What is the difference between a restroom and bathroom?
Bathroom is in the home.
Hola.
Uh-huh. Bathroom is at home. Okay.
The restroom is in the
public areas. Okay, it's a public area. Also, a bathroom will have a shower. To bath, okay?
Okay.
A restroom only. Trono. Right? Just the throne, right? So the tronito. That's the restroom. And that's why we see in the mall, is in the mall, for example, this restroom, right? Because you know, that's where people just, you know, access to physiological necessities. Right? So, okay. So that's the difference, right? Okay, so let's look at the appliances. Do you know what appliances are?
Yes. Refrigerator.
Yes, so those are appliances. Creo que en español, tenemos nombre para eso. Los, no, no son utensilios. ¿Sí? ¿Se recuerdan una palabra for appliances en español?
Uh-uh.
Bueno, so again, it's to the refrigerator, the kitchen, right? Appliances, okay? So,
chef.
What?
Dishwasher.
The dishwasher, yes. Okay, so which appliances can we see here? Tell me what appliances you see.
Refrigerator.
Refrigerator, okay.
Stove.
The stove, okay.
The what are you using to? Oh, the iron.
The iron machine. And then back here you have this gray one. What is this gray one?
Which one?
You put bread.
Vacuum.
No, but see by the broom, there's a broom. And on the shelf, what do we have here on the shelf? Next to the broom. On the shelf.
Toaster.
A toaster, very good. See, it's on the shelf next to the broom, right? Okay.
On the shelf next to the
broom. Now, on the floor next to the broom, what do we have? On the floor next to the broom, what do we have? On the floor next to the broom, what do we have on the floor? What do we have on the floor next to the broom? Do you know what is? ¿Pero la ven? ¿Saben de qué estoy hablando?
Del recogedor
sí,
de basura.
La palita que está abajo.
Okay. Right. So first of all, qué bueno porque me entendieron las instrucciones. That's good. Next, on the floor next to the broom. So you have what is called dust pan. What you use to pick up the dust. Dust pan. All right? So it's D, como David, U-S-T, dust, de polvo, no? Pan, P-A-N, dust pan.
Dust pan. Okay.
Yes, that's what you use to pick up the dust. Dust pan.
Dust pan.
So this, of course, is a broom, right? What is Sharon holding?
Mop, the mop.
Mop, M-O-P, mop, right? All right, what about Ben?
That's the vacuum.
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 A vacuum cleaner, okay?
A vacuum cleaner.
Vacuum cleaner, okay? Okay, so we saw Jeff holding an iron, very good. Okay, and we have, what are these called? Everything is called dishes. Dishes, right?
Mm-hmm. Now,
this is a plate. Plate, plate. And that one for the cereal, what is that called? The one we use for the cereal?
Bowl.
A bowl. B-O-W-L, right? A bowl. And then, of course, you have cups, right? Coffee cups. Spoon. Knife, fork, right?
Fork.
Spoon, knife, fork.
Fork.
All right. And you have a trash bag, right? This is a trash bag. And this is a trash can, right? Trash can, C-A-N, and trash bag. B-A-G, trash bag, all right? Okay, so we have a broom, so stove, right? And they're cooking. So they're cleaning the bathroom, they're emptying the trash, they're mopping with double P-P, I-N-G, mopping the floor, okay? One second, please. All right, mopping the floor. And vacuuming the rug. Okay. Ironing. Ironing clothes. So you wash, are you washing, and you have washing the your clothes, right? And you can also do ironing. I-R-O-N-I-G, ironing.
Ironing. Ironing.
Okay. And vacuuming. Bien. So I want you to take note aquí arriba cómo se escriben las acciones, okay? So you have cleaning, emptying, mopping, vacuuming, ironing. Please write those down. Okay. And you see mop, the verb is M-O-P. But we add ing is mopping. M-O-P-P, ing. Remember that one? Okay. The same with empty. Empty, F-E-M-P-T-Y, ing, emptying. Iron is I-I-O-N, ing, ironing. Okay?
Okay.
All right. So we're going to go move on to any questions regarding the picture. Nope. It stops. You have electric stuff and gas stuff, right? Electric or gas. All right. So I want you now to look at page, what is it? 111. And you will have the audio that you're going to listen. You're going to use it for A and B, okay? For both. A and B. A and B. So that's going to be unit 9. Oh, all the way down. Page 111, okay? Exercise 2, A and B. It works for both. Remember the type of exercise we had in the past.
Unit 9, Daily Living. Page 111. Exercises 2A and 2B. Track 31. Conversation A.
Did you wash the clothes?
No, I didn't. But Rachel did.
She did? When?
She washed them last night.
Good for her.
All right, so for the first one, conversation A, we're going to circle which word we listen. Last night, right? And we put A on the drawing number 3. Correct. Number 3, right? A. All right. Here we go. So the same for B, C, D, E, and F, okay? Here we go.
Conversation B.
Did you pay the bills?
Yes, I did.
Are you sure? When?
I paid them yesterday morning.
That's great. Thank you.
Conversation C.
Susie, did you clean the bathroom?
No, I didn't. But Rita did.
Oh? When did she clean it?
She cleaned it the day before yesterday.
Okay, good.
Conversation D.
Hey, the rug is really clean. Did you vacuum it?
Yes, I did.
Did you do it last Friday?
I vacuumed it every day last week.
Every day? That's wonderful.
Conversation E.
Did Alice dust the bookshelves?
Yes, she did.
Oh, that's good.
Yes, I told her yesterday.
Well, I'll thank her.
Conversation F.
Ralph, did you mop the floor or did Victor do it?
I mopped it.
When?
Last night.
Well, it's dirty again.
Okay. You finished or you want me to repeat it?
You finished. Finish.
Okay, perfect. All right. So, what do we have in picture number 1?
B.
B.
Little B.
Okay. So B is a boy. Okay. And when was that?
Yesterday morning.
Yesterday morning. Very good. What do we have for picture number 2?
F.
F is a prank, okay? And when was that?
Last night.
Okay. What about picture three?
A.
Okay.
Little A.
When was that?
Last night.
Last night. Very good. Number four.
Little C.
And when was that?
The day before yesterday.
Okay. What about five?
D.
Okay. And when was that?
D. Every day last week.
Very good. What about number six?
E.
And when was that?
Yesterday morning.
Okay. When was E? Yesterday morning?
Yesterday.
Yeah, only yesterday. Okay? Yesterday for E. Okay? Now, class, what day is today?
Today is Tuesday.
Okay. So, here's what I want you to do. Look at your answers for A, B, and C, D, right? So I want you to tell me the day and the time. So for example, if today's Tuesday, answer was last night. So when was last night?
Monday.
Okay, so it was Monday night. Okay. What about B?
Yesterday morning.
And when is that? So I want you to tell me the day. Okay?
Oh, yesterday morning. Mm-hmm. Monday.
Monday morning.
Very good. Okay. What about C?
The day before yesterday.
Sunday. Very good. Okay. D.
Every day and Sunday.
What's D?
Every day last week.
Okay, so what day is that?
Saturday and Sunday?
No. Every day last week.
7 days a week.
No.
All days?
Actually, no. Monica was correct. Every day, 7 days, every day in the week, okay? Now, si hubiera dicho every weekday, what is that?
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, right?
Si hubiera dicho every last weekend, then bet hubiera sido Saturday and Sunday, right? Mm-hmm. Weekend, right? Okay. Okay. So I just want us to review the day before yesterday. Okay. Perfect. So you understand that. Okay. Now, where would a partner put the word from the box in the correct category? Okay. So if you look at number three, I want you to fill the table. Okay, lléneme la tabla, all right? Fill the table.
Disculpe, Lía, ¿cuál tabla?
On number three, Monica.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Page 111. One second, please. Hello? Okay. All right, so, 1 second. Okay. The table is number 3, Monica, okay?
Yeah, I got it.
All right. One second, okay? I'll let you guys finish. All right. Go over it. Well, I'll be right back. Once you finish, discútalo con ustedes, okay? Give me 1 minute. Okay.
Dijo que lo revisáramos entre nosotros.
Oh, vamos a revisarlo, pues, entonces, ya.
Iron.
Gruez.
Archer. Asher.
Empty.
Trash. Vacuum.
Vacuum. The floor.
The floor.
Bueno.
My apologies. Ready? No lo vi que lo discutieron entre ustedes. ¿Qué pasó?
Sí.
Okay. So is this what you had? Is this what everybody has? A dress?
Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yes, teacher.
The floor.
What? ¿Qué pasó, hija? Alicia, were you asking me something? No.
Yes, ready.
Okay. Yes, so the floor, the rug, a bill, a ticket, right?
Yes.
All right, so those are the things you, part of your daily living, right? Daily living quiere decir las cosas que se hacen a día. Daily es diario, right? Living, lo que haces a diario, right? Mm-hmm. All right. All right, now let's look at page 112. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So it's a simple past con verbos regular verbs. ¿Cuáles son los regular verbs?
Past.
Do you remember?
Los verbos regulares son los que se le agrega ed.
Okay, they don't change, right? Irregulars are the ones that you change. Correcto?
Yes.
Alicia, give me one example so irregular verbs are clean, right?
Yes. Yes. So
give me an example of an irregular verb.
Verb regular is clean, cleaning.
Okay, how about an irregular verb?
El irregular es el que está abajo, ¿verdad?
Okay, can you, for example,
dice,
English.
Do.
No, yeah, do, did, done, right? Irregular, right?
Irregular.
Or forget?
Do, did, done.
Right. How about forget?
Yeah.
Con who am I forget?
¿Cómo? How?
Forget. ¿Cuál es el past y el simple past? Forget.
El past y el simple past y el participio.
Dígame, forget.
¿Cuál verbo?
Forget, el verbo forget. Olvidar.
Los tres.
Can anybody help? Claudia?
Forgot.
Forget, okay, forget, forgotten.
Forgot.
Okay. All right, so those are irregular verbs. Okay, so you already know that, that we only add ED, right? Le agregamos ED. Y hay algunos que cambian, right? Como dry, drive. Empty, emptied. Mop, que le llamamos double P, ED, right? We have seen this in the past, correct?
Mm-hmm.
You remember that. Okay. So, when you want to make a statement es una a sentence, una oración, y, which is the question, answers, is an answer for the statement, right? So, I clean, past tense, right? The living room. You clean, he clean, she clean, they clean. Si esto fuera present, present, I clean, you
clean.
You clean.
She clean.
He what?
You clean.
Yeah.
Cleans. Okay, very good. ¿Verdad?
Clean.
So sabemos que en el present es que cuando agregamos la tercera persona, le agregamos la S, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Cuando está yes, en el pasado, solo agregamos ED, nada más, correcto? No hay S que agregar, right?
Yeah.
Like I clean, you clean, he cleans. Ve que se queda igual para todos, correct?
Para todos, okay.
Okay. Now, cuando estamos haciendo negativo, le agregamos
didn't.
Okay. ¿De dónde viene? Del verbo. ¿De qué verbo viene didn't?
Verbo do.
Verbo to do. Very good. Okay. So, do, did. ¿Y cuál es el past participio?
Done.
Very good. Done. Do, did, done, right? Okay, so do, y el negativo de did not, right? Is didn't, right?
Didn't.
So I didn't clean. So cuando ponemos, así como hemos visto los otros, que si ya tenemos un negativo pasado, el verbo no se modifica. Observa, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, ya no podemos decir, I didn't clean it. No. Right? Van a decir, yeah. I didn't clean.
Yeah.
Ok. So, esto nuevamente son las cosas que diferencian su inglés. Si ustedes ya están poniendo el negativo aquí en pasado, no tienen por qué poner el verbo en pasado. Ok.
Mm-hmm.
So, ustedes no van a decir, I didn't clean it. Or even, I didn't spoke to you. No. Right? Si yo no estoy poniendo el did, entonces si digo I spoke to you, right? I spoke, que es el pasado, ¿correcto? Speak, spoke, spoken, ¿verdad? So, no, lo correcto es, I didn't speak to you. Right? Porque lo vamos a utilizar en su forma natural, el verbo, como el clean, como el speak, no lo va a poner spoke. Por ejemplo, cuando dice, did you watch the movie? I didn't watch. No van a decir, I didn't watch it, the movie. Right? So, si ya tenemos aquí el do en el subpasado, que es el did, en este caso en activo, didn't, el verbo se queda igual. ¿Entienden eso? ¿Estamos claros ahí?
Yes.
All right. So, I clean, este estaba en pasado, the room. Pero como aquí le puse I didn't, este lo dejo en su forma natural. I didn't clean, ¿correcto? So, let me ask you. Si este fuera I did, le agrego, no didn't, pero en afirmativo, I did, le agrego ed a este o no?
No.
No, ¿ok? ¿Por qué? Porque el pasado ya lo estoy diciendo acá. Entonces no van a decir un doble pasado, por decirlo así, ¿ok?
Ok.
Vale. So, en el presente, sí modificamos al igual, y esto aplica lo mismo para el did. Ojo con esto, fíjense qué interesante. Acababa de decirle que aquí cuando hablamos del presente clean, ¿verdad? Yo no digo I clean, yo digo I clean, you clean, he cleans, ¿verdad? Pero cuando decimos en el pasado, el clean es exactamente lo mismo para todos, ¿correcto? ¿Recuerdan eso que lo acabo de mencionar, verdad? So, lo mismo es para el verbo do. I, en el presente, ojo, I do my homework. You do your homework. He does the homework, right? Pero cuando estoy hablando en pasado, igual que como aquí no modifico el verbo en pasado con clean, lo mismo aplica para do en pasado. I did my homework. You did your homework. Mónica did her homework. ¿Ok? So ahí no hay el did es, se queda, es no. No se conjuga diferente, ¿ok? Al igual que los presentes, los verbos en pasado, perdón. Ok. So, I didn't clean, you didn't clean, he didn't clean, she didn't clean, they didn't clean. Now, for a question, como siempre, antecedemos con el to do. Did you clean yesterday? So, primero el did en pasado, ¿no? El sujeto, you, they, she. El verbo en su forma pura, clean. Y luego el momento. ¿Ok? Did you clean yesterday? Did he clean yesterday? Did she clean yesterday? ¿Entendemos esta parte? So, por ejemplo, si yo te quiero preguntar, vamos a ver, Fanny, si yo te quiero preguntar que si comiste esta mañana, ¿cómo te haría la pregunta?
Did you eat in the morning?
Okay, did you eat breakfast or a meal this morning? Very good. Okay. Did you? So, vamos a ver. Mónica, pregúntale a Claudia si ya se bañó.
Claudia, did you take a shower?
Yes, I do.
Right. Mónica, repeat the question, please.
Did you take a shower?
Did you take?
Take a shower.
And the answer, Claudia?
Yes. I did. Yes, I do know. Yes, I did.
Yes,
I did.
Complete sentences. Yes, complete sentences.
Yes, I did a shower. I take a shower.
I did take a shower. Okay. So, ¿cuál es el presente del verbo, Mónica? ¿Cómo conjugamos el verbo tomar? Dime los tres.
I take.
¿Cuál es el primero? ¿Cuál es el presente?
I took.
Was it take, took, taken?
Yes.
Okay. So that's why you said, did you took? Or did you take? Did you take?
I say did.
Okay, did take. Take. Okay, take. Porque ganamos el present, right?
Yes, did you take a shower?
Yes, this morning.
Yes, I did. Yes, I did.
Did take.
Yes, I did
this
morning.
So, lo que quiero es que si ella hubiera dicho, yes, I did took a shower, o I. So, pregunta. Dígame si está correcto o no. Ella dice, yes, I did take a shower this morning. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, si ella dice, yes, I did took a shower, is that correct?
¿Cómo es la segunda?
Yes, I did took a shower.
No, incorrect.
No,
incorrect.
Porque no podemos
estar. Si ella dice, yes, I take a shower this morning, is that correct?
No.
Si ella dice, yes, I took a shower this morning, ¿está correcto?
Correcto.
All right. Entendemos los cuatro escenarios, right? So, si tienes el did, no tienes por qué hablar del pasado el verbo. Very good. All right. So, did you clean yesterday? Yes, I did. No, he didn't. And we already spoke was yesterday, the day before. The day before yesterday and last night and last week. Questions? No? All right, I want you to do 2A now. Look at the picture and complete the sentence. So look at the pictures and complete the sentences 1 to 6. Finished? We finish.
Falta, falta.
Okay. Morning, Arjen. Good morning.
Good morning. Sorry. Good
morning. We are in page 112. Exercise 2A. 112, 2A. So look at the picture and complete the sentence. According to what you see in the picture, de acuerdo a lo que ven en la picture, you have to complete the sentence. Utilizando did, didn't, y el past. Simple past. What? Ready, Claudita?
Es que ahorita le hice una pregunta a mi hijo para
which one?
Si había captado y lo hice mal porque yo le dije you clean your room.
No, para empezar si le primero es pregunta. Entonces, ajá, la pregunta ajá, tiene ajá. que empezar con qué.
Ajá, entonces ya ahorita cuando dije, porque aquí estoy mirando que question es, did you clean yesterday? Ajá. Did you clean your room yesterday?
Exacto. So, ajá. Primero, si vamos a hacer pregunta, nos vamos a dejar de, you clean your room yesterday? No, eso no es pregunta. Aunque por más que le quieras meter al final así la entonación, ¿right? Uh-huh. Si es pregunta, para utilizamos el verbo do en pasado y presente, ¿verdad?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Como mencionamos, utilizamos did y el sujeto, you, y el verbo, lo que le quieras preguntar, en su forma presente, ¿right?
Okay.
Y okay. sin agregar S o nada, sino que puro. Did he clean? Did you clean your room yesterday?
Okay, yeah. Thank you.
Very good, pero está bueno que esté practicing.
Con razón me miró con ojitos medio raros y me dijo, oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, so let's look at number two. So what is answer for number one? Exercise 2A. Look at the picture. Yusef?
Yusef cooked dinner. Yusef cooked dinner.
Right? Cooked dinner, right? Because he's eating, right? That's yes. how we know. Okay, number two.
He didn't clean the kitchen.
He didn't clean the kitchen. Very good. So, vamos, didn't, right? Subject, he didn't clean the kitchen. Very good. What about number three?
He didn't dust the shelves.
Mm-hmm. What about number four?
He didn't wash the dishes.
Number five.
He ironed the shirt.
Okay. Y si ocupo el did, ¿cómo lo diría?
He didn't iron the shirt.
No, no. Afirmativo, porque sí lo hizo.
Oh. Okay. He did iron.
Very good. So recuerden que lo que mencionábamos, que cuando utilizas el did, right? Aquí está bien. Si no ocupé el did, ¿verdad? Ocupo el verbo con el pasado ed, right? He ironed the shirts, como ustedes me dijeron. Pero yo puedo utilizar el did, puedo decirlo y es formal y correcto que yo diga. La única diferencia es que cuando yo digo he ironed the shirts y cuando yo digo he did iron the shirts, al estar utilizando el verbo do and did antes, lo hace como más, ¿cuál es la palabra? Más preciso, más marcado, ¿me entienden? Como que estoy haciendo note, o sea, como que les estoy haciendo de ver que de veras las planchó, ¿ok? So cuando yo digo he did iron the shirts, lo estoy... El did antes del iron me hace verlo como que más enfatizado la oración. ¿Me explico? Es como que más, wow, ¿sabes? Como si yo estuviera más, por ejemplo, si yo les preguntara, did he iron the shirts? Y yo les digo, yes, he did iron the shirts. El he did iron the shirts está demostrando que yo estoy como que más seguro que sí lo hizo. Y dependiendo del tono, como yo ponga en la voz, puede ser que esté... you know, sorprendido o que si te quiero haber remarcar eso. Por ejemplo, listen, did he iron the shirts? Yes, he did iron the shirts. Entonces ahí es como que yes, he did iron the shirts. Entonces lo estoy como enfatizando más. Si yo digo yes, he ironed the shirts, it's correct too. Okay? All right, so what about number six?
He didn't empty the trash.
Very good. So, once again, no utilizamos el pasado, empty it, ¿verdad? Sino ocupamos el verbo en su presente y utilizamos el did antes, ¿ok? ¿Vale?
Right?
Ok. So, básicamente, hemos dicho, número uno, para hacer preguntas, Claudita, nunca más antes vamos a decir solamente, vamos a poner el do and did antes, right?
Ok.
Cuando le preguntemos así a nuestros hijos si hicieron la tarea, did you finish your homework? Right? Did you wash the dishes? Did you make your bed? Okay? Y sabemos ahora que cuando contestemos en el pasado agregamos ed, pero si estamos poniendo el did o didn't, el verbo se queda en su presente. Yes.
Okay.
All right. So now let's move on to number exercise 2B, page 113. Argen, ¿comprende lo que hicimos?
Sí, Eli.
¿Estamos bien? ¿Tiene dudas?
Sí. Voy a repasar la clase.
Para hacérselo rapidito, es bien fácil. Mire okay. Aquí arriba. Si usted, el pasado, sabemos que el pasado de los verbos regulares solamente le agregamos ed, ¿correcto? Uh-huh. O sea que I clean the living room está en pasado. Ahora, cuando agregamos el verbo do en su negativo, en su pasado, did y didn't, El punto que quiero hacerle ver acá es de que usted en ningún momento va a venir y... Hola, ¿eh? Me vino a visitar. Say hi to the class. Hey. Angie, mira, aquí me vino a visitar también a mí, ¿eh? All right. So ustedes en ningún momento va a modificar el verbo, ¿ok? Se queda,
se queda en pasado.
Se queda en su presente.
Ah.
Y didn't.
Did y didn't presente.
Yeah. O sea que si usted está poniendo, ya, ¿por qué? Porque si no está haciendo un doble pasado, ¿me entiende? Ya conjugó el did, que es pasado de do. Por lo tanto, no hay necesidad de poner en el pasado el siguiente verbo, clean. La otra parte que hablábamos es que ya no vamos a preguntar, ya no vamos a hacer preguntas. ¿You clean yesterday? No, eso no es una pregunta. La pregunta es, ¿did you clean yesterday? So la respuesta, usted va a decir, yes, he did. Did you clean? No, he didn't clean. Right? All right. So now let's look at 2B. Look at the picture, answer the questions, okay? It's the same exercise. Look at the pictures, and according to the picture, you answer the question. Did Mr. Ramirez mop the floor? And then please put me the other question.
Did Mr. Ramirez empty the trash?
Okay, bueno. Let me know when you finish. Okay?
Yeah.
We ready?
Yes. Ready.
All right. So number one. So we're gonna do this. Arjen, A and B. One the question, one the answer, and B the answer, okay?
Okay.
So I'm gonna be A for you, Argentina. Did Mr. Ramirez mop the floor?
Yes, he did
mop the floor. Okay. Let's see. Angie, pregúntemele a Claudia.
Number two?
Yes, please.
Did Mr. Ramirez empty the trash?
Mr. Ramirez?
Did Mrs. Ramirez?
Mrs. Ramirez. Póngase los lentes, está bien. Mrs. Ramirez.
Ya lo miro, niña. Ah, pues yo tampoco miraba. Did Mrs. Ramirez empty the trash?
Yes, she did.
Okay. So, give me complete answers, please.
Okay, vamos a tocar.
A ver, Claudita, ¿cómo sería la complete answer ahí?
Oh, yes, she? Yes, she did empty the trash.
Okay, she did empty the trash. Okay. Let's see. Bepsi, I'm going to ask you. Did Mr. and Mrs. Ramirez wash the dishes?
No, they didn't wash
the dishes. They didn't wash.
No, they didn't wash the dishes.
No, they didn't wash the dishes. Very good. Alicia, let me ask you. Did Roberto dry the dishes?
Yes, he did dry the dishes.
Okay, could you repeat that for me, please?
Okay. Yes, he did dry the dishes.
All right, so practiquemos más el yes, 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 yes.
Yes.
¿Va? No me pongamos la yes, sino que yes, ¿verdad? Como yes, right? Yes.
Okay.
All right.
Yes, he did dry the dishes.
Very good, very good. All right. Who do I have next? Monica there? Yes. Monique, did Ash, no, Monique, did Luis vacuum the rug?
No, he didn't vacuum the rug.
All right. Fanny, did Monica vacuum the rug?
No, she didn't vacuum the rug.
No, she didn't?
No, she didn't.
Why? Why no?
Because not right in the floor, not right.
Look at the rug, it's sparkling. Tiene hasta le pusieron ahí estrellitas.
Maybe he thinks me.
I'm sorry.
No, Monica happens to be the same Monica that's in the picture too. So did Monica in the picture back in the rug?
Yes, she did. She did back in the rug.
Yes, she did back in the rug. Sí, Monica dice que no hiciste un buen trabajo y mira hasta estrellitas le sacaste el vacuum.
Siempre hago eso.
All right. Okay, so let's move on to number three. Says, talk with your classmate, write their names, okay. And then you're gonna ask, okay? So, let's start. Argentina, make a question to ask Claudia.
Claudia, cooked dinner the last night.
Eso no es question, hija.
Did you cook the dinner the last night?
Okay, did you cook dinner last night?
Yes, I cooked dinner last night.
Okay. So, Argen, fíjate, aquí ella tiene dos maneras de contestarte.
I did.
Te pudo haber dicho, yes, I did cook dinner last night, o como hizo la segunda, que te dijo, yes, I cook. Con LED, ¿me entiendes?
Ajá.
O sea que si ella, la misma respuesta te la puede decir, pero si ella utiliza el did, ya el cook ya no le vas a agregar LED, porque ya tienes el did antes, ¿right?
Ajá. Pues si me no puede.
Pero si no le responder. Pongo el did, si no le pongo el did, ¿verdad? Sí le voy a agregar el cook porque estamos hablando de anoche en pasado. Ok. El punto es que nunca vas a hacer. ¿Cuál es el pasado de do?
Did.
Ok. Entonces no vas a poner pasado.
Ok. Pasado y presente.
Ya tengo un pasado de do, ¿verdad? Did. Entonces aquí tengo mi presente de cook, de watch, lo que sea. Ahora, si yo en mi oración no te estoy pasando, estoy colocando el pasado de do, o sea, did, entonces para que sepas que es pasado, tengo que meter entonces definitivamente el cook con ed, right?
Okay.
Okay. So, yo te puedo contestar. I did cook dinner. Porque did y cook sin ed. Okay. O te puedo contestar. Yes, I cooked dinner. Ahí sí le tengo que poner el ed. ¿Por qué? Porque no te estoy poniendo el pasado antes de eso, right?
Ok.
Right? So lo que tienes que pensar es que nunca debo decir pasado de do con pasado del verbo. está incorrecto. Okay. Okay?
Sí.
Por ejemplo, tienes este watch y watch, ¿verdad? De haber visto, ¿no? So, I did watch TV last night. Si no le pongo el did, entonces tengo que agregarle I watch con el ed TV last night. All right?
Okay.
Okay. So, por ejemplo, igual cuando tiene, mira number two. Emptied the trash yesterday. Eso está en presente o en pasado.
Pasado.
Ok, porque presente del verbo, ¿cuál es el presente del verbo?
Empty.
Empty.
Empty con Y, right?
Sí,
uh-huh.
Y dice yesterday.
Ajá, y dice yesterday, pero sobre todo es que el verbo está con ed, right? Okay. So, si yo voy a hacer la pregunta, lo mismo aplica para hacer la pregunta. Primero, para hacer una pregunta, tengo que poner el did, ¿verdad? Empezar la pregunta con eso. Y el verbo lo voy a dejar en presente o en pasado si ya puse el did antes.
En pasado.
En presente, ya pasa el verbo, es el did.
Estoy poniendo el did, entonces aplica lo mismo. No puedo poner pasado, pasado. ¿Ok?
Ok, ok.
So, si yo, así como les dije, si yo te hago la pregunta, did you empty? ¿Ya? ¿Por qué? Porque ya te puse el pasado de do and did, ¿correcto? Entonces no puedes poner pasado, pasado. So la pregunta tiene que ser, did you empty con Y, ¿correcto? No ed. Did you empty? Y eso es lo que tienen que acordarse, no puedo tener pasado, pasado. So yo te voy a preguntar, did you empty the trash yesterday? Y tú me puedes contestar. Yes, I did empty con Y, ¿verdad? Porque tengo pasado presente. Yes, I did empty the trash yesterday. O omito el did y te digo, yes, I emptied the trash can yesterday. All right? So, clave, pasado, pasado no existe. Ok, si estoy utilizando el pasado de do, que es did, no tengo por qué utilizar el pasado del verbo del que esté hablando. Right. So, for example, a ver, Argen, pregúntemele a Alicia la número dos. Conviértame en una pregunta. No, Argen.
Did you empty the trash yesterday?
Okay, Alicia.
Yes, I did. The trash yesterday?
No, I did the trash. No, I did what? ¿Qué hizo con el trash?
Oh, okay. Yes, I do yesterday.
No, ¿qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? All right. So, yes, y fue ayer. Entonces, okay.
I pasado.
Yes.
Yes.
I
trash.
No, I did. Empty. Porque es un verbo. Trash es un verbo. Trash es la basura. Okay.
Empty.
Pero Alicita, porque usted me estaba diciendo, sí, yo hice basura ayer. No.
No. Uh-huh. ¿Por qué pasó?
Porque es pasado y no me estaba metiendo el verbo, porque el verbo aquí no es la basura, el verbo es
empty.
Dar, empty, despaciar la basura, right? Mm-hmm. Empty,
okay? I did the trash.
¿Y el verbo?
Empty.
I did empty.
Empty trash yesterday.
Okay, yes, I did empty the trash yesterday.
Uh-huh. Okay? Yes.
All right, let's try one more.
Okay.
¿Quién tenemos aquí? Betsy.
Yes.
Hágame la pregunta a Fanny. Number three.
Fanny, did you wash the dishes every night last week?
Mm.
Yes. I washed the dishes every night last week.
Okay, so es una manera de contestarla. Very good. Dígame la otra manera de contestarla utilizando el do, did.
Yes, I did wash the dishes every night last week.
Bravo, bravo, bravo. Okay? So, okay. Voy a decir, I wash, con ed, I washed the dishes yesterday. Or yes, I did wash the dishes yesterday. Very good. All right.
Una pregunta. Entonces, para hacer la pregunta, también se puede hacer sin usar el did por delante, por ejemplo.
No, la pregunta nunca.
Jamás.
La pregunta siempre tiene que ponerle el did antes.
Ah, ok.
Las respuestas son las que puedes usar, hijita, puedes utilizar omitiendo el did, que si quitas el did, pues vas a poner el verbo en el pasado, ¿verdad?
Yes.
O poniendo el did, pero como did es el pasado de do, ya el verbo no lo pones en pasado, el siguiente verbo. Okay. Pero las preguntas siempre hay que poner el did. Okay.
O sea que no puedo decir, por ejemplo, you emptied the trash yesterday. Eso ya no es una pregunta.
No, esa es una oración. Por más que le quieras poner you emptied the trash yesterday, por más que le quieras poner ahí, ¿verdad? Es una oración.
Ok.
Es pregunta si le pones el do or did you. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Uh-huh. Es como que, yo creo que en español decimos, bueno, lo que pasa es que creo que no existe esa forma en español, porque para yo preguntarte, ¿lavaste los platos ayer? So, no hay manera. Claro que sí. En el español perfecto es, ¿habéis lavado los platos ayer? ¿Eh? ¿Sí o no, Arne?
Yes.
Sí, habéis lavado, ese es el do. A ver, el verbo do. ¿Habéis lavado los platos ayer? Acá. Pero en el español usualmente decimos, ¿lavaste los platos ayer vos? Right? ¿Eh?
¿Has lavado los platos ayer?
¿O has lavado los platos ayer? Ok. Exacto, pero el has es del do, de hacer, right?
Yeah.
Has lavado. Pero usualmente, igual que usualmente en inglés informal o en el español informal, decimos, ¿lavaste los platos ayer?
Uh-huh.
Y ustedes escuchan que en inglés también informalmente dicen, ¿you washed the dishes yesterday? No. Lo correcto es, ¿did you? Right? Ok.
Yeah.
Ahora, la respuesta de igual manera es, yes, I did wash the dishes. El did es el pasado, el wash es normal. O, y en español sería sí. No, pero en español no aplica, porque igual diría, he lavado los platos ayer. Ah, no, he lavado o lavé. Anyways, ¿estamos? No vamos a confundir más en español. All right. So, last one. Vamos a ver, nos faltan dos más. Vamos a ver si es cierto. Claudita. Pregúntemele a Alicia. Number four.
Oh. Did you dry the dishes the day before yesterday?
Oh, wait. Actually, sorry. That's number one, two, three, four. Number five.
The vacuum.
Who did?
The vacuum last weekend.
Pero aquí le está preguntando, ¿dónde está el sujeto? Escúchese otra vez. Did.
Did. Vacuum.
¿Quién? Me falta el. Tenemos el did, está bien, pero me falta el subject.
Did you vacuum last weekend?
Sin el ed, ¿verdad? No le ponemos el ed. Did you vacuum last week? Okay. A ver, Alicita.
Yes, I did last weekend.
I did vacuum last week.
Vacuum last weekend.
Okay. Creo que se nos está olvidando poner eso, ¿ok? Alicia, y ahí lo que tiene que hacer es solamente práctica, practique, practique, hágase usted misma preguntas, ¿ok? Para que se acostumbre a contestar formalmente la respuesta completa. O sea, está bien que diga, yes, I did, fine. Pero la forma completa es, yes, I did, el verbo vacuum, que estamos hablando, vacuum
last week. Last week. Okay. Yes, I did vacuum last week.
Ok. All right, let's see. Vamos a ver. Moniquita, pregúntemele a... ¿A quién me falta? A Betsy. La, nombre, la última, por favor.
La six.
Number six, yes.
Did Monica... ¿Did Monica vacuum the rug?
No, mam. Estamos, ya pasa, estamos aquí en on this, in the column. Yeah, I want you to ask Betsy. Ask Betsy, did you?
Sorry, me paré a Lías, no estaba en clase. Ah. ¿Dónde estamos?
Aquí ve.
¿Qué página es?
113.
Okay.
Iron clothes last week.
Okay. Betsy, did you iron? I mean, do you iron the cloth last week?
Yes, I did iron cloth last week.
Okay, Betsy. Y si no ocupo el did, ¿cómo sería?
Yes, I ironed clothes last week.
Very good. Ahí sí le meto el ID, ¿verdad? Porque no estoy poniendo el did, so no hay pasado, pasado. Very good. Questions. Before we move to lesson C. ¿Preguntas antes que sigamos? No? Ok. So lo que tienen que recordarse clave es, uno, si es una pregunta, le tengo que meter el did. Ok? Did you, did he, did I, did they, did you, did you, did you. Hay que meterle el did. Dos, le meto el did. Y el verbo, como ya puse un pasado, no tengo que meterle pasado en ningún otro lado a esa pregunta. Did you cook? No, did you cook? Right? Answers. Lo puedo contestar igual, pasado, presente. Si yo digo, I did wash. Okay, the dishes. Si no le pongo el did y era pasado, ahí sí le meto el ed. I washed the dishes. Okay, I washed the dishes yesterday. Right, so eso es lo que tiene que recordarse. No puedo tener, es pasado, pasado, no. Pasado, presente, pasado, presente. Okay.
Teacher.
Ya pusimos el do en su pasado de did, todo lo demás tiene que quedar en presente. El verbo, right? Okay.
Teacher.
Yes.
Sorry. Y también esto es igual para this thing is same for the negative.
Yes, it's the same for the negative. Didn't.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you.
So I didn't, como ya lo puse en negativo, lo demás es positivo. Como ya lo puse en presente, en pasado, el verbo se queda en presente de en adelante. Lo mismo aplica para el did o didn't. Okay.
No didn't wash the dishes. No washing the dishes.
Yes. So, okay. Lo mismo es para el did o didn't, ¿ok?
Ok, thank
usted
you.
Puede hacer preguntas negativas. Como por ejemplo, en vez de, did you wash the dishes? Puedo hacerte una pregunta negativa, pero esas son, suenan medio, no son polite. Didn't okay. You wash the dishes? Que es lo mismo que, ¿no lavaste los platos? Ok, ¿me estás preguntando o me estás diciendo que no lo hice? ¿Me explico?
Uh-huh.
Entonces ya es ya suena más acusatorio, ¿no? Cuando haces ese tipo de preguntas. So, polite, o sea, educadamente, no deberías de hacer preguntas negativas.
Okay.
Al menos que estás seguro que no lo hizo, entonces mejor dile al el statement que no lo hizo. en vez de preguntarle, right? Okay. Okay. So now we're going to look at simple past. Okay? Que básicamente es lo mismo que acabamos de estar hablando, que hablaba de pasado, no con pasado, pero que le llamamos LD. Pero en este caso está hablando de los verbos irregulares, que sabemos, como mencionamos antes, que son los que no les agregamos ed, right? So, aplica lo mismo. So, I paid, pasado, ¿verdad? Why? Porque teníamos pay, paid, paid, right? So, I paid the bills. I didn't, ya tengo el pasado acá, por lo tanto este lo dejo en su presente, right? I didn't pay the bills. Let's take a look at by. So, ¿cómo conjugamos by? By, bought, right? Okay, so that means que I buy the groceries, I bought the groceries. I did buy, okay? Or I bought. Espérenme que esta se le fue el huesito aquí.
What do you want?
Here. Sorry. Okay. Okay, so let's look at the statement. I paid the bills. He paid the bills. She paid the bills. They paid the bills. Paid. I didn't pay. No, paid. I didn't pay the bills. He didn't pay the bills. Y en esto es lo otro que mencionábamos también, que el did no es modificado en tercera persona. Okay? So, he didn't pay the bills. She didn't pay the bills. They didn't pay the bills. So, ¿cómo sería la pregunta aquí si yo le quiero preguntar a alguien que si pagó los bills o no? ¿Cómo le preguntaría?
Did you pay the bills?
Okay, very good. That's, did you pay the bills, right? Did you pay the bills? Yo te contestaría, I didn't pay the bills. Right. So, we have questions of who and what. So, who bought groceries last week? ¿Por qué dice bought? Es el pasado de buy, right? So, who bought groceries last week? I did. I did buy groceries last week. O puedo decir, I bought groceries last week. So, who bought groceries last week? He did. He did buy groceries last week. Or, puedes contestar, he bought groceries. What did she buy? She bought groceries. So, again, si pongo el pasado acá, did, el verbo se queda en su normal. Si no utilizo el did, entonces lo pongo en pasado el verbo, right? Did. Como no hay did, bought. So we have irregulars here. Buy, get. Do, did, make, made, pay, sweep, swept. So I can ask you, vamos a ver. I get what? I get breakfast every morning, right? I get breakfast every morning. Did you get breakfast this morning? Yes, I did get breakfast this morning. O la otra sería, si no utilizo did, ¿cómo lo respondería? Yes, I got breakfast this morning. ¿Los veo perdidos? Hablen. Es lo mismo que allá arriba. ¿Se recuerdan cómo allá arriba dijimos que si utilizo el did, la única diferencia es que estos son verbos irregulares, o sea que no agregan el ed, right? Porque su pasado no es ed. Entonces es lo mismo. Si estoy utilizando el did, no voy a utilizar el verbo en su pasado. Right, let's practice. Okay. All right. So for example, look at the picture. Last night, 2 a.m., right? Last night, Linda had to pay the bills. But first, she... ¿Cuál es el pasado de buy? Bought groceries, right? She bought groceries after work. She, ¿cuál sería el number two ahí?
Paid
$15. She got home. Very good, Alicia. And she
made
very good dinner. She
made
soup and salad. After dinner, she was very tired. She
swept
the kitchen floor, but she
not paid.
She did not pay the bills. So look, right?
Paid the bills.
After war, she paid $15. El pasado del regular bear, right? Gotten, right? So she got a home. She got home and she made, right? So she made dinner. She made soup and salad. After dinner, she was very tired. She swept the kitchen floor, but she didn't or did not pay the bills. Okay? Right, so look at the notes and answer the questions. Let's see. Betsy, could you read the first note? Read the first note to me, please.
115.
In page 115, yeah, the very one on the top.
Mom, thanks for buying the groceries. I vacuumed the rug in the living room. Love, Eric.
Okay, very good. Let's see, Monica, read this, the one for that. Page 115.
Dad. Okay. I got the mail and made the bed. Can I have my allowance now?
Sasha. All right. Very good. Claudita.
Mm-hmm. Sasha?
Yes.
Sasha, I cut the grass, but I didn't do the laundry. Can you do the laundry, please, Dad?
All right. So, esta es cut. Okay. I cut the grass. Okay, no cut, cut. Okay? ¿Viste, Claudita?
I cut. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. I cut. cut the grass. Bye. So si ustedes ven aquí, I didn't, pasado, ¿no? Present, I didn't do the laundry. Can you do the laundry, please? All right. Let's see, who's next? Fanny. The blue note, can you read the blue note?
Okay. Sasha, I did the laundry, your allowance?
Allowance?
Okay. Your allowance is on the table. Have fun at the movie theater. Mom.
Very good. Okay. So, let's look at the notes and let's answer. Number one, who bought the groceries?
Mom did.
Mom did. Okay, no Erika. Porque dice mom.
Gracias.
Writing the note thinking mom, it's Erika, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, very good. So mom did. Number two, who made the beds?
Dad.
Sasha.
Dad, this?
No. Sasha did.
Who made the bed?
Sasha got the mail.
Sasha did make the bed, okay? Okay, number three, who vacuumed the rug?
Erika did.
All right, Erika. Very good. Number four, what else did Sasha do?
She got the mail.
He made the bed.
She got the mail, no? She got the mail, very good. All right, number five, what did Dad do? Claudia?
He cut the grass.
He cut the grass. Okay. And number six, what else did mom do?
She did the laundry.
Very good. She did the laundry, right? Because Sasha said, you know, she's writing a note. Mom is writing a note in blue to Sasha, right? Sasha, I did the laundry. Okay. Do you know what allowance is? ¿Saben qué es allowance?
Allowance is for many? Money?
Yes, the money she gets from her parents every week. Allowance is money. ¿Verdad? Como la, what's that in Spanish?
Mesada.
La mesada. Mm-hmm. Okay. Allowance. Okay. So, what? Let's wrap it up. I'm on did. All right. So talk to your partner and I ask, make questions, okay? Well, Betsy, for example, Betsy, who paid the bills at your home?
Yes, I did. Yes, my husband paid the bills.
Okay, your husband paid the bills? Okay. All right. Claudia, I want you to ask Monica.
Monica, who is about the groceries?
Okay, let's try the question again. Monica, who what?
Monica, who Mm-hmm. Bought the groceries.
Very good. Monica, who bought the groceries?
Erica bought the groceries.
Okay. But this is about you, okay?
Okay, I brought the groceries?
Yeah, it's about you, okay?
Okay.
O sea, utilizando tu casa, all right?
Oh, she asked me who brought the groceries.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, it's about me. I brought the groceries.
Okay, I bought the groceries last week.
I brought the groceries every week. Okay. Every weekend. I mean, every Saturday.
Okay. So, una observación aquí nomás. Okay. Si lo vas a decir every Saturday, significa que es continuo. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Te explico. So, if you're going to say, I buy the groceries every weekend. Ahora, si tú dices every, porque estás utilizando el every.
Mm-hmm.
Ahora, si tú dices, I bought the groceries last weekend, entonces lo pones en pasado. ¿Ok?
Okay, got it.
Bien, right? Because if I buy the groceries every weekend, es ahora, pasado y el futuro, right?
Indefinido.
I buy. Okay. Now, si yo quiero utilizar, ay, miren, Claudia showing off her chuchito también. Está bonito, miren, todos tenemos, somos racistas porque todos tenemos perros blancos. Oh my God.
Sí. Say hi, bye. Say hi, bye.
Ay, Claudia, mira. Another white dog. Oh my God, we're racist. Ya le voy a decir a Leandro lo racistas que somos.
Y Leandro tiene puros negritos.
Leandro tiene puros negritos. Anyway, right? So you understand every, right? Last, si le ponemos el pasado, okay?
Yeah, right. Got it. Thank you.
All right, let's see.
Oh, Eli, mm-hmm. Entonces también podría ser I have bought the groceries every Saturday.
Sí, porque lo está refiriendo como que.
Como que es algo
continuo usual. Que lo ha hecho. Ya, yeah, pero okay. Hay que agregarle every Saturday for the last week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
Si lo deja, I had bought the groceries every Saturday, lo deja estar dejando como que en el aire, okay? Every Saturday, okay. Todos los sábados, ¿qué? Since last year, for the last year, okay. Y ahí sí lo haría más completa la oración, ¿no? Okay, so let's see. ¿Quién nos queda aquí? Fanny. Okay, vamos a ver. Hágame la pregunta a Alicia about the laundry.
Okay. Alicia, who did the laundry? Alicia, who did the laundry yesterday?
Okay. Yes, I did the laundry every weekend.
I do the laundry. Ahí lo vamos antes. Si le va a poner every, ahí no puedo utilizar pasado. Okay?
I do the laundry every weekend.
Ahora, si va a utilizar pasado, I did the laundry yesterday, I did the laundry on the weekend. Okay.
Hay que usar el do, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right.
Yes, I do the laundry every weekend.
Okay. All right. So if I go, I wash the dishes. I can ask you, Argentina. Or I can ask, for example, Claudia. Claudia, did Argentina wash the dishes? Okay? Hoy estamos utilizando dos personas. I'm asking Claudia if Argentina did the dishes. Okay? So I can go like, Claudia, did Argentina wash the dishes. Okay? So Claudia can answer to me. What will your answer be, Claudita? Claudia, did Argentina wash the dishes?
The answer?
Yes.
Oh, my daughter.
No, listen to my question. Listen.
Oh.
Did Argentina, Argen, right? Your classmate, Argentina. Did Argentina, Claudia, did Argentina wash the dishes? So, Claudita, I'm asking you, ¿tú sabes para empezar? Do you know?
No, no.
So you don't know because you don't live with Argentina, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Claudia, did Argentina wash the dishes?
Argentina wash the dishes?
Did she wash the dishes?
I don't know.
Okay. You don't know? No, I don't know. That's your answer. Porque tú no vives con Argentina, no sabes si lavó o no los platos ayer, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, vamos a asumir que sí los lavó, okay? Porque tú lo fuiste a visitar a El Salvador. All right? So, yo te puedo preguntar a ti. Claudia, did Argentina wash the dishes yesterday? ¿Cómo me contestarías?
Yes, she didn't.
Uy, yes, she didn't?
She did wash the dishes.
Very good. Yes, she did wash the dishes, okay? Pero que quería que practicáramos cuando te están preguntando a ti sobre alguien más. So, cuando te están preguntando a ti sobre alguien que hizo a otra persona, la respuesta obviamente lo vas a poner el subject de la otra persona. Yes, she, he, we, they, okay?
Right? Okay.
Okay. Okay, guys. So, read, practice, okay? And if you have any questions, we'll talk tomorrow. Okay?
Okay.
So, tomorrow we'll do D, E, and F. Esto es más que lo practiquen, okay?
Sí.
Y vamos a hacer un jueguito mañana con esto, right? Okay.
Thank you, Ellie, teacher.
Happy Teacher's Day.
Oh, thank you. Today's Teacher's Day. Thank you.
Today?
Yes.
Oh. Congratulations and thank you very much for everything.
You're welcome. You're most welcome.
Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye. Thank you.